A center sprung throttle is where your throttle stick automatically centers vertically in the gimbal, so it works in the same way that the cyclic stick does. In this video, we'll go over how to set it up, what changes in your flying, and is it really worth it? Each transmitter has a different way of centering the throttle. In my case, I contacted Mikado in Germany, and they sent me a rocker and a spring which is installed into the transmitter. Then you need to calibrate the sticks to make sure you're outputting exactly zero at the center. In the V-bar control, you'll find it under transmitter setup, then stick calibration. Long press on collective calibrate and set zero. And now the throttle stick shows zero every time you let go. And finally, you'll want to make sure your model has 0 degrees of pitch at center. So if you go into setup, and then trims. The stick is already in the middle, so there's no eyeballing or trying to line up the indicators on the gimbal. You just need to make sure that you have 0 degrees on the blades. Now that we know we have zero, let's go fly. The first thing you'll notice is that you don't need to touch the collective during spool up. Obviously, it's advisable to have your fingers on the sticks, but now it's easy to find zero and let the model spool up without being pushed into the ground or lifting early. Spool down is the same, no more model being hammered into the ground, although you'll want to keep an eye on it, especially on windy days where it could lift. Next, you can check that you really have zero by doing tail slides and seeing if the model goes one way or the other. It should come down dead straight. You can do a similar thing with a roll or two on the way down. One other check I like to do is the hover drop test. This is where you descend with the sticks in the center. It doesn't come down fast at all with 0 degrees, so you have lots of time. Then do the same inverted, and they should have similar descent speeds. When flying, there are some things to watch out for. Here we have a bit of wind. And when we go vertical with the sticks in the middle, you can see the model is being blown backwards. For the next stall turn, we know the wind direction and strength, and when we go vertical, we give the collective a little negative to keep things straight. And that looks a lot better. So this works really well with set maneuvers, where you know what the wind is doing and how the model is going to react. Here we're going to do some rolls on the way down with the collective at zero. And you can see that the model is moving with the wind. So on this one, we'll start with a bit of negative to hold it, and when we start rolling, we'll alternate the collective with an equal amount of positive as the blades turn into the wind. And flying wise, it's not much more than that. Over time, your fingers will be aware of how far the stick is from center, and it will become as natural as using the cyclic control. I don't think a sprung collective is for everyone. It suits me because I fly helicopters 99% of the time, and I'm at a stage where the benefits outweigh any negatives. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for someone who does F3C, flies fixed wing, or is learning to fly. I think they aren't going to be able to take advantage of knowing where zero is, and having something extra to think about will slow them down. Autorotations are an area that I hadn't considered where it would make much of a difference, but happily, it does. First, you'll notice you can do 0 degree autorotations. I've linked to the 0 degree video in the description below, but in effect, you'll be able to autorotate with the collective in the middle and the blades at 0 degrees. This is a well-known phenomenon used by helicopters and gyrocopters, and it works on model helicopters too. The RPM will slow a little more than it would for regular autos, but with a bit of wind it has more than enough head speed to land safely. Obviously, it works just as well inverted. Here I do the same thing, but I start the auto upside down and let the sticks go to center. The RPM drops off some and then stabilizes. I dive a little bit at the end to give me more head speed before I initiate the rollout. Where it really helps autos though, is that you now know when you're at zero, negative, or positive collective. This allows for very high autos where you can't see the blades or hear them, but you can put the collective at zero and then as the model drifts, you counter that with the cyclic. Then, as you're doing aerobatics on the way down, you're rolling and pirouetting, and all the time you know exactly how much collective is being applied. Do a half roll, and you put the collective the other way. It really does make it super easy. The first time I tried hovering with a sprung collective many years ago, I didn't like it. I found that where there is a change of rudder direction, the collective would bounce as the stick crossed from left to right and back. If you do decide to use a center sprung throttle and you prefer an F3C style hovering pitch curve, you may want to adjust your curve so that you don't hover at center stick. If you hover at center, it's not smooth as you go from climb to drop, as you may be pulling down and then switching to pushing up, which will jar and not transition well. I found it easier to change the pitch curve to hover above center, so you're only pushing the sticks up and then relaxing to bring it down. And leaving the sticks in the center can be set to keep the model planted on the ground, so it doesn't go anywhere, which is useful for F3C. If you find a better way of doing this, let me know in the comments below. There are some alternatives to a center sprung throttle that may offer some benefits. First off is the Stick Clic app from Mikado. You can find this in the Mikado app shop under extensions. To use this, you need to set the system volume to where you can hear it. Then you need to set the position, alert type, and alert width or range. This vibrates or beeps each time the collective goes through the position. Some people have found it useful, but personally I can't see it being effective at finding zero, as the alert will always be too late and you don't actually know if you're above or below. In addition, it cannot be turned off during normal flight and it may drive you absolutely potty during TikToks. Another one I've heard about is putting a dent or a groove in the gimbal friction plate so that you can feel zero. I've not tried this, but I've heard that it works well enough, as long as it's subtle. Anything more and I think it would become irritating, and also rough for hovering. In conclusion, a center sprung throttle can be useful, but it's not a silver bullet. You won't suddenly be doing maneuvers that you've never done before. It will take practice to use properly, and it may not suit where you are with your current skills. In fact, it may even slow you down. But if it does work for you, it makes some things a lot easier and it certainly won't hold you back. Until next time, good luck.